Alright guys, this video is about 10 everyday things that you probably do your hair that is not so good for it. Some of these things you're going to be like, yeah, I already knew that. Some of these things you're going to be like, what, really? Okay, so first everyday thing that you do to your hair that isn't that good for it, don't brush your hair. No. What? Brushing your hair isn't good for it? Surprise, surprise, but no, brushing your hair is actually really bad for your hair. So, I mean, I'm not saying never brush your hair, but if you have someplace to be and your hair just looks like a rat's nest, so you're obviously gonna have to brush it. But like, right now, see, passing on my seat or something, doesn't need to be brushed. It's fine. Don't, if you're like a chronic brusher and you're wondering why you have split ends everywhere, the second thing on our list is never brush your hair when it is wet. Brushing your hair when it is wet is horrible for your hair, okay? Your hair is so fragile when it is wet. You pretty much just should leave it alone. Don't just leave it alone. The next thing. Always brush from the ends up. Don't brush. Don't start from the top of your head and brush down. It's bad. Whenever you brush your hair, always start from ends up and work. Whatever, just scratch that out. My shirts aren't all over actually. Alright, the third thing on the list is always brush from your ends. Never brush your hair. Whenever you brush your hair, never start at the top of your head. If you start up here and brush down just straight like that, it's bad for your hair. Because if there is any knots, you're just going to rip it out of your hair, which means you're ripping your hair out. So what you want to do is start from the bottom and work your way up. Because if you start from the top and your knots in there, it's just going to get bigger and you're going to rip them out of your hair and it's going to be painful and it's going to mess up your hair. Don't do it. Alright, our fourth one is another one that has to do with wet hair. Do not put your hair in a ponytail when wet. Like I said, your hair is very fragile when it's wet. Taking a tight elastic band and wrapping it around that is not a good idea. All this is going to do is spread that ponytail escaping on your hair. It's just going to break it. Not a good idea. Okay, the fifth thing on our list doesn't apply to everyone, but it's something that applies to me, so of course I thought of it. If you have frizzy or curly hair, don't use volumizing shampoo and conditioner. It's very simple and that's the one. So if you have curly or frizzy hair, you use volumizing shampoo and conditioner. And everything is good for the hair, but you want to dry, your hair is just so frizzy and it's the texture is really rough. The reason for this is pretty simple. Your hair has hair. Curly or frizzy hair has the biggest pores, alright? It's like as big as a pore can get. Curly hair or frizzy hair has huge pores. Are you with me? Now, people with flat hair or hair that just lacks volume use volume on shampoo. And the reason it gives them volume is because what all that shampoo does is open up your pores. So, it will make a flat person with flat, volumized hair will make their pores bigger because they already have a kind of pore. So it makes their pores bigger so their hair gets volumized. Now, when you do it on hair that is already very big, all it does is widen your pores to where your pores are just so wide they're connecting like this. And your pores shouldn't be they're just huge. And that's why your hair gets frizzy, because if your pores in your hair are that huge, think if you had huge pores in your face, think how much dirt would get in there, think how many pimples you get, think how unhealthy that would be for your face. That's what you're doing to your hair. That's why it doesn't feel good when you touch it, that's why it's frizzy, that's why it breaks. Don't use volumized shampoo if you already have thick hair or curly hair or frizzy hair. Just don't. So our sixth thing is UV rays. UV rays are bad for your hair. Because your hair is very fragile. I'm pretty white. Okay, if I get a border, I would prefer hosting, but I'm a freaking bird. Or if I go back to my life, I would accept some hosting, and I'm a freaking bird. The hair is just as fragile as your skin. You can use planet protection. It's kind of like hairspray, but instead of necessarily, it doesn't really make your hair feel the way hairspray does. It protects your hair from humidity, UV rays, static, and wind. So it's kind of like hairspray, but like if you want your hair to like stay locked in place while you're going to be that much of help, it'll be a little bit of a help. Maybe if you have frizzes and stuff like that. But it's really just to protect your hair from outside stuff. Number 7. Washing your hair every day. Okay, so let me explain how washing your hair works. First, you use shampoo. And what the shampoo does is it takes all the dirt and stuff like that. It does not. It pretty much takes everything out of your hair. It just strips your hair. It doesn't just strip your hair of the dirt and grease and grime that you get throughout the day. It strips your hair of all the proteins and all the oils that it naturally needs to be healthy. That's what the shampoo does. That's why you use conditioner after the shampoo. Because the conditioner tries to put the good stuff that the shampoo is taking away back into your hair. But obviously the shampoo is not going to be as healthy as it's already naturally in your hair. So, the best thing is not to wash your hair every single day, but every other day. And now if you do have naturally greasy hair, this obviously isn't going to apply to you. But you're going to have to wash your hair because you can't walk around looking like you have wet hair because it's so greasy. And if you have wet hair because it's so greasy, you don't condition every day. You have too much oil. You don't need it all. What you need to do is wash your hair every day or whenever it gets oily and condition when needed. Like every 2 days, every 3 days, maybe one deep condition a week. It just depends on how oily the hair is. So if you don't have oily hair, you don't need to be washing it every day, period. Our 8th thing on our list is use of heat on your hair. Now, a lot of us should already know this, that heat is bad for your hair. Blow drying your hair, ooh, that is bad on your hair, because like I said, your hair is most fragile when it's wet. Straightening your hair, obviously that can be bad, and you never straighten your hair when it's wet. I don't care if those straighteners say wet to straight. That doesn't mean it's good for your hair, okay? Never do that. You're literally boiling your hair. Would you take your hair and dip it in a pan of boiling water? No. So then why would you take your hair and boil it? Okay, you are boiling it to the extent the water in your hair is evaporating. Come on, how does that sound healthy to you? Okay, so if you are going to blow dry your hair or use heat on it or whatever, there are ways to protect your hair. And for blow drying, I use this. I use this for blow drying my hair. It's called Blow Dry Addict. Because I have such frizzy, curly, crazy hair that sometimes if I do not blow dry it, it's not going to be straight, no matter how much I try to straighten it. But I use this stuff because it works. And it's also really good for thick hair. Because if you have really thick hair, you know that it can take like an hour and a half to blow dry your hair because it is so thick, it is hard to get everything dry. And I mean, literally, today I took a shower, and in 3 hours, all my hair was still not done drying. I still had like in the back, in the middle part of my hair, it was all still wet. That's how thick my hair is. So, if I say this stuff is good for helping you blow dry your hair faster, I'm serious. It works. And then, for straightening hair, I have heat protecting it, but it's not in here. My mom stole it. It's like Ion stuff. And then, Qi has their stuff, and Qi's is pretty good. It's like this little red, expensive, crazy, that's why I steal from my mom, Qi bottle. And you just spray it in your hair and then brush it through your hair and then straighten it. And it, like, I mean, the heat's still knocking on your hair, but you're doing less damage. The 9th thing on our list is touching your hair. You can probably tell that I touch my hair a lot. In this video, I've already touched it a crap ton. The reason it's not good is pretty obvious. Hands are dirty. And it's like if somebody's eating or they're eating greasy foods, all that stuff stays on your hands. Or if you have a friend who's like a chronic, uses lotion just chronically, he's like, oh hey, can I play with your hair? And then after they play with your hair, you touch your hair and it feels suddenly dirtier than before they were playing with it. That's because all those oils and crap and lotion just got all up in your hair. So now body lotion is all up in your hair. So that's why I say, you know, I mean, if you know your hands are clean, it's not as bad. Like, I know my hands are clean, but you need to be careful when you let other people touch your hair. All right, the last thing on our list, number 10. The shampoo and conditioner you use. Yep, the shampoo, like I told you earlier, if you have curly hair, don't use volumizing shampoo. This applies to other people and other things too. If you have oily hair, there are certain shampoos and conditioners that's just going to make that worse. If you have really dry hair, there are certain shampoos and conditioners that are going to make your hair more dry. You need to make sure you're doing the right kind of shampoo for your hair type. Now, I'm not going to sit here and explain what kind of shampoo you should get for what hair type, because that would be like a whole nother video. Now that you know all these daily things that you do to your hair that isn't so great for it, maybe if your hair is not so great right now, you know, just try changing a couple of these everyday things. It's not that hard, it's really easy, and you might see like a really big improvement in your hair, because once I found this oil, I was like, what? Really? That's so easy! That I had to edit it 2 different times. Because the first time I completely got done editing it, and somehow, not my fault, it completely deleted itself. Just straight up deleted itself. Like an hour of work, and I'm like, what the heck? Are you kidding me? So I actually like shut my computer off, tossed it, and I was like, screw this. I'm not messing with this. I was mad. And then today before work, I was like, you know what? I did a stupid video. I know it's not a great video, but I'm just going to edit it and post it anyways, because I didn't spend all that time for nothing. So yeah, I just wanted to say that please enjoy this video, because I worked really hard on editing this 2 times. And the only reason it's so quiet is because everyone was asleep and I didn't want to wake anybody up. Anyways, like my video and subscribe. Later.